And what can you do, my effeminate fellow?
According to all known laws of aviation, there's no way a bee should be able to fly! Its wings are too small to get its fat little body off the ground! The bee, of course, flies anyway! Because bees don't care what humans think is possible! Yellow, black, yellow, black, yellow, black, yellow, black! Oh! Black and yellow! Let's shake it up a little! Barry! Breakfast is ready! Ooming!
Oh, I think it's supposed to say, coming, but whatever.
Hang on a second! Hello? Barry? Adam? Can you believe this is happening? I can't! I'll pick you up! Looking sharp! Use the stairs! Your father paid good money for those! Sorry! I'm excited! Here's the graduate! We're very proud of you, son! A perfect report card! All B's! Very proud! Ma! I got a thing going here! You got lint on your fuzz! Oh! That's me! Wave to us! We'll be in row 118,000! Bye! Barry! I told you! Stop flying in the house! Hey! Adam! Hey, Barry! Is that fuzz gel? A little special day! Graduation! Never thought I'd make it! 3 days! Grade school! 3 days high school! Those were awkward! 3 days college! I'm glad I took a day and hitchhiked around the hive! You did come back different! Hi, Barry! Arty, growing a mustache looks good! Hear about Frankie? Yeah! You going to the funeral? No, I'm not going! Everybody knows, sting someone, you die! Don't waste it on a squirrel, such a hothead! I guess he could have just gotten out the way! I love this incorporating an amusement park into our day! That's why we don't need vacations! Boy, quite a bit of pop under the circumstances! Well, Adam, today we are men! We are! Be men! Amen! Hallelujah! Students, faculty, distinguished bees, please welcome Dean Buswell. Welcome, New Hive City, graduating class of 915. That concludes our ceremonies and begins your career at Hunnex Industries. Will we pick our job today? I heard it's just orientation. Heads up, here we go. Keep your hands and antennas inside the trap at all times. Wonder what it's be like. A little scary. Welcome to Hunnex, a division of Hunnisco and a part of the Hexagon Group. That is it. Wow. Wow. We know that you, as a bee, have worked your whole life to get to the point where you can work for your whole life. Honey begins when our valiant pollen jocks bring the nectar to the hive. Our toxic formula is automatically color-corrected, scent-adjusted, and bubble-corn-turned into this soothing, sweet syrup with its distinctive golden glow you know as Honey! That girl was hot. She's my cousin. She is? Yes, we're all cousins. Right, you're right. At Hunnex, we constantly strive to improve every aspect of bee existence. These bees are stress testing a new helmet technology. What do you think he makes? Not enough? Here we have our latest advancement in crewmen. What does that do? Catches that little strand of honey that hangs after you pour. Saves us millions! Can anyone work on the crewmen? Of course! Most bee jobs are small ones, but bees know that every small job, if it's done well, means a lot! But choose carefully, because you'll stay in that job you pick for the rest of your life! The same job the rest of your life? I didn't know that! What's the difference? You'll be happy to know that bees, as a species, haven't had one day off in 27 million years! So you'll just work for us to death? We'll sure try! Wow, that blew my mind! What's the difference? How can you say that? One job forever? That's an insane choice to have to make! I'm relieved! Now we only have to make one decision! them? How could they never have told us that? Why would you question anything? We're bees! We're the most perfectly functioning society on Earth! You even think maybe things don't work a little too well here? Like what? Give me one example! I don't know! But you know what I'm talking about! Please clear the gate! Royal Doctor 4th are approaching! Wait a sec! Check it out! Hey, those are pollen jugs! Wow! I've never seen them this close! They know what it's like outside the hive! Yeah, but some don't come back! Hey, jocks! Hi, jocks! You guys did great! You're monsters! You're sky freaks! I love it! I love it! I wonder where they were! I don't! Their day's not bland outside the hive! Flying who knows where! Doing who knows what! You can't just decide to be a pollen jug! You have to be bred for that! Right! Look! That's more pollen than you and I will see in a lifetime! It's just a status symbol! Bees make too much of it! Perhaps! Unless you're wearing it and the ladies see you wearing it! Those ladies, aren't they our cousins too? Distant! Distant! Look at these two! Couple of hive fairies! Let's have fun with them! It must be dangerous being a pollen jock! Yeah, once a bear pinned me against a mushroom! He had a paw on my throat! And with the others, he was slapping me! Oh my! I never thought I'd knock him out! What were you doing during this? Trying to alert the authorities! I can autograph that! A little gusty out there today, wasn't it? Comrades! Yeah, gusty! We're hitting a sunflower patch 6 miles from here tomorrow! 6 miles? Huh? Barry! A puddle jump for us? But maybe you're not up for it! Maybe I am! You're not! We're going 0900 at JK! What do you think, Buzzy Boy? Are you bee enough? I might be! It all depends on what 0900 means! Hey, Hunnix! Dad, you surprised me! You decide what you're interested in? Well, there's a lot of choices, but you only get one! Do you ever get bored doing the same job every day? Son, let me tell you about stirring! You grab that stick, and you just move it around, and you stir it around! You get yourself into a rhythm! It's such a beautiful thing! You know, Dad, the more I think about it, maybe the honey field just isn't right for me. You were thinking of the what? Making balloon animals? That's a bad job for a guy with a stinger. Janet, your son's not sure what he wants to go into honey. Barry, you're so funny sometimes. I'm not trying to be funny. You're not funny. You're going into honey. Our son's a steerer. You're going to be a steerer? No one's listening to me. Wait till you see the sticks I have. I could say anything right now. I'm gonna get a tattoo. Let's open some honey and celebrate. Maybe I'll pierce my throat. Shave my antennas. Shack up with the grasshopper. Get a gold tooth and call everybody dog. I'm so proud. We're starting work today. Today is the day. Come on. All the good jobs will be gone. Yeah, right. Pollen counting, stun beam, pouring, steerer, front desk, and removal! Is it still available? Hey God, two left! One of them is yours! Congratulations! Step to the side! What do you get? Picking crud out! Styler! Wow! Couple of newbies! Yes sir, our first day! We are ready! Make your choice! You wanna go first? No, you go! Oh my! What's available? Restroom attendance open! Not for the reason you think! Any chance of getting the crewman? Sure, you're on! I'm sorry, the crewman just closed out! Wax monkeys always open! The crewman opened up the gate! What happened? A bee died! Makes an opening! See? He's dead! Another dead one! Deadly! Deadified! Two more dead! dead from the neck up, dead from the neck down. That's life. Oh, this is so hard. Heating, cooling, stunt B, poorer steerer. I'm in inspector number 7, link coordinator, strike supervisor. Might Wrangler Barry, what do you think I should do? Barry! Alright, we've got the sunflower patch in corn 9. What happened to you? Where are you? I'm going out. Out? Where? Out there. Oh no! I have to before I go to work for the rest of my life. You're gonna die! You're crazy! Hello? Another call coming in! If someone's feeling brave, there's a Korean deli on 83rd! That gets their roses today! Hey guys! Look at that! Isn't that the kid we saw yesterday? Hold it! Sun flight decks restricted! It's okay, Lou! We're gonna take him up! Really? Feeling lucky, are you? Sign here! Here, just initial that. Thank you. Okay, you got a rain advisory today. And as you all know, bees cannot fly the rain. So be careful. As always, watch your brooms. Honey sticks, dog birds, bears and bats. Also, I got a couple of reports of root beer being poured on us. Murphy's in a hole because of it! Babbling like a sister! That's awful! And a reminder for your rookies! B1 number 1! Absolutely no talking to humans! Alright! Lost position! Buzz! Black and yellow! Hello! You ready for this? Hot shot! Yeah! Bring it on! Wind check! Antenna check! Nectar pack! Check! Wings check! Stinger check! Skin out of my shorts! Check! Okay, ladies! Let's move out! Pound those petunias! You striped stem suckers! All of you! Drain the flowers! Wow! I'm out! I can't believe I'm out! So blue! I feel so fast and free! Pox kite! Wildflowers! This is Blue Leader! We have Roses visual! Bring it around 30 degrees and hold! Roses! 30 degrees, Roger! Bring it around! Stand to the side, kid! It's got a bit of a kick! That is one nectar collector! Ever see pollination up close? No, sir! I pick up some pollen here, sprinkle it over here, maybe a dash over there, a pinch on that one, see that? It's a little bit of a magic! That's amazing! Why do we do that? That's pollen power! More pollen, no flowers, more nectar, more honey for us! Cool! I'm picking up a lot of bright yellow! Could that be daisies? Don't we need those? Copy that visual! Wait, what do these flowers seem to be on the move? Say again? You're reporting a moving flower? Affirmative! That was on the line! This is the coolest! What is it? I don't know, but I'm loving this color! It smells good! Not like a flower, but I like it! Yeah, fuzzy! Chemical Y! Careful, guys! It's a little gravy! My sweet Lord of Bees! Candy Brain, get off there! Problem! Guys, this could be bad! Affirmative! Very close! Good ahead! Mama's little boy! You're way out of position, rookie! Coming in at you like a missile! Help me! I don't think these are flowers! Should we tell him? I think he knows! What is it? Match point! You can start packing up, honey! Because you're about to eat it! Yowzers! Gross! There's a bee in the car! Do something! I'm driving! Bye, bee! He's back here! He's gonna sting me! Nobody move! If you don't move, he won't sting you! Freeze! He blinked! Spray him, Granny! What are you doing? Wow! The tension levels out here is unbelievable! I gotta get home! Can't fly in the rain! Can't fly in the rain! Can't fly in the rain! Mayday! Mayday! Be going down! Ken, could you close the window, please? Ken, could you close the window, please? Check out my new resume! I made it into a float out the shore! You see? Float out! Oh no! More humans! I don't need this! What was that? Maybe this time! This time! This time! This time! This time! This! Drips! That is diabolical! It's fantastic! It's got all my special skills! Even my top 10 favorite movies! What's number one? Star Wars? Nah! I don't go for that kind of stuff! No wonder we shouldn't talk to them! They're out of their minds! When I leave a job interview, they're flabbergasted! Can't believe what I see! There's a sun! Maybe that's the way out! I don't remember the sun having a big 75 on it! I predicted global warming! I can feel it getting hotter! At first, I thought it was just me! Wait! Stop! Be! Stand back! These are winter boots! Wait! Don't kill him! You know I'm allergic to them! This thing can kill me! Why does his life have less value than yours? Why does his life have any less value than mine? Is that your statement? I'm just saying all life has value! You don't know what he's capable of feeling? My brochure! There you go, little guy! I'm not scared of him! It's an allergy thingy! Put that on your resume brochure! My own face could puff up! Make it one of your special skills! Knocking someone out is also a special skill! Right! Bye, Vanessa! Thanks! Vanessa, next week, yoga night, sure can, you know, whatever, you can put kebab chips on there, bye, supposed to be less calories, bye, I gotta say something, she saved my life, I gotta say something, alright, here it goes, nah, what would I say, I'm really gonna get in trouble, it's a B-law, you're not supposed to talk to humans! I can't believe I'm doing this! I've got to! Oh! I can't do it! Come on! No! Yes! No! Do it! I can't! How could I start it? You're like, yes! No! That's not good! Here she comes! Speak! You fool! Hi! I'm sorry! You're talking! Yes, I know! You're talking! I'm sorry! No! It's okay! It's fine! I know I'm dreaming! But I don't recall going to bed! Well, I'm sure this is a very this is a bit of a surprise to me! I mean, you're a bee! I am! And I'm not supposed to be doing this! But they were all trying to kill me! And if it wasn't for you, I had to thank you! It's just how I was raised! That was a little weird! I'm talking to with a bee! Yeah! I'm talking to a bee! And the bee is talking to me! I just want to say I'm grateful! I'll leave now! Wait! How did you learn to do that? What? The talking thing! Same way you did, I guess! Mama! Dada! Honey! You pick it up! That's very funny! Yeah! Bees are funny! If we didn't laugh, we'd cry with what we had to deal with! Anyway, can I get you something? Like what? I don't know, I mean, I don't know. Coffee? I don't want to put you out. It's no trouble. It takes 2 minutes. It's just coffee. I hate to impose. Don't be ridiculous. Actually, I would love coffee. Hey, you want marble cake? I shouldn't have some. No, I can't. Come on. I'm trying to lose some cover micrograms. Where? These stripes don't help. You look great. I don't know if anything about fashion. Are you alright? No. He's making the tie in the cab as they're flies up Madison. He finally gets there. He runs up the steps into the church. The wedding is on and says, "Watermelon, I thought you said Guatemalan. Why would I marry a watermelon? Is that a bee joke? That's the kind of stuff we do. Yeah, different. So what are you going to do, Barry, about work? I don't know. I want to do my part for the hive, but I can't do it the way they want. I know how you feel. You do? Sure. My parents wanted me to become a lawyer or a doctor, but I wanted to be the florist. Really? My only interest is flowers. Our new queen was just elected with that same campaign slogan. Anyway, if you look, there's my hive right here. See it? You're in Sheep Meadow. Yes, I'm right off the turtle pond. No way, I know that area. I lost the toe ring there once. Why do girls put rings on their toes? Why not? It's like putting a hat on your knee. Maybe I'll try that. You're all right, ma'am. Oh, yeah, fine. Just having 2 cups of coffee. Anyway, this has been great. Thanks for the coffee. Yeah, it's no trouble. Sorry, I couldn't finish it. If I did, I'd be up the rest of my life. Are you? Can I take a peek of this with me? Sure, here. Have a crumb. Thanks. Yeah. All right, well then, I guess I'll see you around or not. Okay, Barry. And thank you so much again for before. Oh, that was nothing. Well, not for nothing, but anyway, this can't possibly work. He's all set to go. We may as well try it. Okay, Dave, put the chain. Sounds amazing. It was amazing. It was the scariest, happiest moment of my life. Humans, I can't believe you were with humans. Giant, scary humans. What were they like? Huge and crazy? They talk crazy. They eat crazy giant things. They drive crazy. Do they try to kill you? Like on TV? Some of them, but some of them don't. How'd you get back, Poodle? You did it, and I'm glad you saw whatever you wanted to see. You had your experience. Now you can pick up your job and be normal. Wow, I met someone. You did. Was she bitch? A wasp? Your parents will kill you. No, not a wasp. Spider, I'm not attracted to spiders. I know it's the highest thing with the 8 legs and all. I can't get by that face. So who is she? She's human. No, that's a Pilar. You wouldn't break a Pilar. Her name is Vanessa. Oh boy, she's so nice and she's a florist. Oh no, you're dating a human florist? We're not dating. When you're flying outside the hive talking to humans, that attack of hobs. With power washers and M80s, what a stick of dynamite! She saved my life and she understands me! This is over! Eat this! This is not over! What was that? They call it a crumb! It was so stingy and stripy! And that's not what they eat! That's what falls off when they eat it! You know what is an unbun is? No! It's bread and cinnamon and frosting! They heat it up! Sit down! Really hot! Listen to me! We're not them! We're us! There's us and there's them! Yes, but who can deny the heart that is yearning? There's no yearning! Stop yearning! Listen to me! You have to start thinking B, my friend! Thinking B! There he is! In the pool! You know what your problem is, Barry? I gotta start thinking B! How much longer will this go on? It's been 3 days! Why aren't you working? I gotta think about big life decisions to think about! What life? You have no life! You have no job! You're barely a bee! Would it kill you to make a honey? Barry, come out! Your father's talking to you! Martin, will you talk to him? Barry, I'm talking to you! You got anything all set? Go ahead, I'm ketchup! Don't be too long! Watch this, Vanessa! We're still here! I told you not to yell at him! He doesn't respond to yelling! Then why yell at me? Because you don't listen, Tony, I gotta go! Where are you going? I'm meeting a friend, a girl! Is this why you can't decide? Bye! I just hope she's bitch. They have a huge parade of flowers every year in Princeton to be in the Tournament of Roses. That's every fourth dream. Up on the float, surrounded by flowers, crowds cheering a tournament to the Roses complete in athletic events. No! Alright, I've got one. How come you don't fly everywhere? It's exhausting. Why don't you run anyone faster? Yeah, okay, I see. Alright, your turn. TiVo, you can just freeze live TV? That's insane. You don't have that? We have Ivo, but it's a disease. It's horrible. Horrible disease. Oh my, dumb bees. You must want to sting all those jerks. We try not to sting. It's usually fatal for us. So you would have to watch your temper. Very carefully. You kick a wall. Take a walk. Write an angry letter and throw it out. Work. Do it like any emotion. Anger, jealousy, lust. Oh my goodness. Are you okay? Yeah. What is wrong with you? It's a bug. He's not bothering anybody. Get out of here, you creep. What was that? A pick and save circular? Yeah, it was. How'd you know? It felt like about 10 pages. 75 is pretty much our limit. You've really got that down to science! I lost a cousin to an Italian Vogue! I'll bet! What in the name of Almighty Hercules is this? How did this get here? Addie B. Golden Blossom! Ray Loita, Private Select! Is he that actor? I've never heard of him! Why is this here for people we eat? You don't have enough food of your own? Well, yes! How do you get it? Please make it! I know who makes it! It's hard to make it. There's heating, cooling, stirring. You need all Krellman's thing. It's organic. It's our organic. It's just honey, Barry. Just what? Bees don't know about this. This is stealing. A lot of stealing. You've taken our homeschools, hospitals. This is all we have. And it's on sale. I'm getting to the bottom of this. I'm getting to the bottom of all this. Hey, actor, you almost done, almost. Easy, I sent it. Well, I guess I'll go home now and just leave this nice honey out with no one around. You're busted, Box Boy. I knew I heard something so you can talk. I can talk, and now you'll start talking. Where are you getting the sweet stuff? Who's your supplier? I don't understand. I thought we were friends. The last thing we wanted to do is upset the bees. You're too late. It's ours now. You, sir, have crossed the wrong sword. You, sir, will be launched for my iguana iguana sweet. Where is your honey coming from? Tell me where. Honey farms. It comes from honey farms. Crazy person. What horrible thing has happened here? These facts, they never knew what hit them. And now, they're on the road to nowhere. Just keep still. Why, you're not dead? Do I look dead? They will wipe everything that moves. Where you headed? To honey farms. I am onto something huge here. I'm going to Alaska. Moose blood, crazy stuff, blows your head off. I'm going to take a... And you, he really is dead. All right. Oh no, what is that? Oh no! All right, Bear! Triple blade! Jump on, it's our only chance, B! Why did everything have to be so dog clean? How much do you people need to say? Open your eyes, stick out your head out the window! From NPR News in Washington, I'm R. Castle. But don't kill no more bugs, B! Moose blood guy! You hear something? Like what? Like tiny screaming. Turn off the radio. What's up, B-Boy? Hey, blood. Just a roll of honey. Just as far as the eye can see. Wow. I assume wherever this truck goes is where they're getting it. I mean, that honey is ours. Bees hang tight. We're all jammed in. It's in a closed community. Not us, man. We on our own. Every mosquito is here. his own. What if you get in trouble? You a mosquito, you in trouble. Nobody likes us. They just smack us. See a mosquito, smack, smack. At least you're out in the world. You must meet girls. Mosquito girls, try to trade up. Get with a moth, dragonfly. Mosquito girl, don't want no mosquito. You gotta be kidding me. Moose blood's about to leave the building, so long, B. Hey guys, Moose Blood, I knew I'd catch you down here. Did you bring your crazy straw? We threw it in the jar, slap a label on it, and it's pretty much pure profit. What is this place? A bee's got a brain the size of a pinhead. They are pinheads. Pinhead, check out the new smoker. Oh, sweet. That's the new one you got. That's the new one you want. The Thomas 3000 smoker. 90 puffs a minute. Semi-automatic twice. The nicotine all the time. A couple puffs of this knocks them right out. They make the honey. We make the money. Oh my, what's going on? Are you okay? Yeah, it doesn't last too long. You know, you're in a fake hive with fake walls. Our queen was moved here. We had no choice. This is your queen? That's a man in a woman's clothes. That's a drag queen. What is this? Oh no, there's hundreds of them. Our honey is being presently stolen on a massive scale. This is worse than anything bears have done. I intend to do something. Oh, Barry, stop! Who told you humans are talking to? That's a rumor! Do these look like rumors? That's a conspiracy theory! These are obviously doctored photos! How did you get mixed up in this? He's been talking to humans! What? Talking to humans? He has a human girlfriend! And they make out! Make out! Barry! We do not! You wish you could! Whose side are you on? The bees! I dated a cricket once in San Antonio! Those crazy lake kept me up all night! Barry! This is what you want to do with your life? I want to do it for all of our lives! Nobody works harder than bees! Dad, I remember you coming home for so overworked! Your hands were still stirring! You couldn't stop! I remember that! What right do they have to our honey? We live on 2 cups a year. They put it in lip balm for no reason whatsoever. Even if it's true, what can bees do? Sting them where it really hurts? In the face, the eye? That wouldn't hurt, no. Up the nose? That's a killer. There's only one place you can sting a human where it matters. Hive at 5. The hive's only 4-hour action news source. No more bee beards with Bob Bumble at the anchor desk. Weather with Storm Stinger. Sports with Buzz Larvey and Jeanette Chung. Good evening, I'm Bob Bumble and I'm Jeanette Chung. Our tri-country bee, Barry Benson, intends to sue the human race for stealing a honey, packaging it and profiting from it illegally. Tomorrow night on Bee Larry King, we'll have these former queen here in our studio discussing the new book. All lassie ladies, out this week on Hexagon. Tonight, we're talking to Barry Benson. Did you ever think I'm a kid from a hive? I can't do this. Bees have never been afraid to change the world. What about Bee Alongus, Bee Gandhi, Bee Jesus? Where I'm from, we never sue humans. We were thinking of stickball or candy stores. How old are you? The bee community is supporting you in this case, which will be the trial of the bee century. You know they have a Larry King in the human world too. It's a common name. Next week, he looks like you and has a show and suspenders and colored dots. Next week, glasses, quotes on the bottom from the guests, even though you just heard them. Bear week next week. They're scary, hairy, and he lives. Always leans forward, putty shoulders, squinty eyes, very Jewish. And Dennis, you attack at the point of weakness. It was my grandmother. Dad, she was 81. Honey, her head, her backhand's a joke. It's not gonna take advantage of that. Quiet, please. Actually, go. What going on here? Is that same B? Yes, it is. I'm helping him sue the human race. Hello, B. This is Ken. Yeah, I remember you, Timberland's size. 10 and a half. Vibrant, so I believe. Why does he talk again? Listen, you better go, because we're really busy working. But it's our yogurt night. Bye-bye. Why is yogurt night so difficult? You poor thing. You two have been at this for hours. Yes, and Adam here has been a huge help. Fasting. How many sugars? Just one. I'm not to use the competition. So why are you helping me? Bees have good qualities, and it takes my mind off the shop instead of flowers people are giving balloon bouquets now. Those are great. If you're three in artificial flowers, oh, those just get me psychotic. Yeah, me too. Bed stingers, pointless pollination. Bees must hate those fake things. Nothing worse than daffodil. That's hard work done. Maybe this could make up for it a little bit. This lawsuit's a pretty big deal, I guess. You sure you want to go through with this? I'm sure. When I'm done with this, the humans, they won't be able to say, honey, I'm home, without paying a royalty. It's an incredible scene here down in Manhattan, where the world anxiously waits before the first time in history we will hear ourselves if a honeybee can actually speak. What have we gotten ourselves into here, Barry? It's pretty big, isn't it? I can't believe how many humans don't work during the day. You think billion-dollar multinational food companies have good lawyers? Everybody needs to stay behind the barricade. What's the matter? I don't know. I just gotta chill. Well, if it isn't the B team, you boys work on this. All right, the Honorable Judge Bumbleton presenting. All right, case number 4,475. Superior Court of New York, Barry B. Benson v. The honey industry is now in session. Mr. Montgomery, you're representing the five food companies collectively. A privilege. Mr. Benson, you're representing all the bees of the world. I'm kidding. Yes, Your Honor. We're ready to proceed. Mr. Montgomery, your opening statement, please. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, my grandmother was a simple woman. Born in a farm, she believed it was man's divine right to benefit from the bounty of nature's God put it first. If we live in the topsy-turvy world Mr. Benson imagines, just think of what would it mean. I would have to negotiate with the silkworm for the elastic in my britches, talking bee. How do we know this isn't some sort of holographic motion picture captured Hollywood wizardry? They could be using laser beams, robotics, for all we know, he could be asteroids. Mr. Benson, ladies and gentlemen, there's no trickery here. I'm just an ordinary bee. Honey's pretty important to me. It's pretty important. All bees were invented. It made it, and we protected it with our lives. Unfortunately, there are some people in this room who think they can take it from us, because we're the little guys. I'm hoping that after this all over, you'll see by taking our honey, you not only take everything we have, but everything we are. I wish he'd dress like this all the time. So nice. Call your first witness. So Mr. Klaus of Honey Farms. Big company you have, I suppose so. I see you also own Honey Butter and Honey. Yes, they provide beekeepers for our farms. Beekeepers, I find that very disturbing term. I don't imagine you employ any bee freers. Do you know? I couldn't hear you now. because you don't free bees, you keep bees. Not only that, it seems you thought a bear would be the appropriate image for your bee, honey. They're very lovable creatures. Yogi Bear, Frozen Bear, Build-A-Bear. You mean like this? Bears kill bees. How do you like his head crashing through your living room? Biting into your couch, splitting out your throw pillows. Okay, that's enough. Take him away. So, Mr. Sting, thank you for being here. Your name intrigues me. Where have I heard it before? I was with a band called the Police. You've never been a police officer, have you? No, I haven't. No, you haven't. And so here we have yet another example of bee culture casually being so low human. For another month, Prince around stage name. Oh, please. Have you ever been stuck, Mr. Stink? Because I'm feeling a little stuck, Stink. Or should I say Mr. Gordon M. Summer? That's not his real name, you idiots. Mr. Liona, first, belated congratulations on your Emmy win for guest spot on ER in 2005. Thank you, thank you. I see from your resume that you're definitely handsome with a churning inner turmoil that's ready to blow. I enjoy what you do. Is that a crime? Not yet, it isn't. But is this what it's come for you? Exploiting tiny helpless beasts so you don't have to rehearse your part and learn your lines, sir? Watch it, Benson. I could blow right now. This isn't good, fellas. This is bad, fella. Why doesn't someone just step on this creep? And can we all go home? Order the court. Or you're just all thinking it. Order, order. I say it! Mr. Liona, please sit down! I think it was awfully nice of that bear to pitch in like that. I think the jury's on your side. Are we doing everything right legally? I'm a florist, right? Well, here's to a great team. To a great team. Well, hello. Cat, hello. I didn't think you were coming. No, I was just late. I tried to call, but the battery. I didn't want all this to waste, so I called Barry. Luckily, he was free. Oh, that was lucky. There's a little left. I could heat it up. Yeah, heat it up. Sure, whatever. So I hear you're quite a tennis player. I'm not much for the game myself. The ball's a little grabby. That's where I usually sit, right? There, Ken was looking at your resume, and he agreed with me that eating with the chopstick really isn't a special skill. You think I don't see what you're doing? I know how hard it is to find the right job. We have that in common, do we? Bees have 100% employment, but we do jobs like taking the crud out. That's just what I was thinking about doing. Ten, I let Barry borrow your razors for this fuzz. I hope that was all right. I'm going to drag the old stinger. Yeah, you do that. Look at that. You know, I've just about had it with the little mind games. What's that, Italian Vogue? Mamma mia, that's a lot of pages. A lot of ads. Remember what Ben said? Why is your life more valuable than mine? Funny. I just can't seem to recall that. I think something stinks in here. I love the smell of flowers. How do you like the smell of flames? Not as much, water bug. Not taking sides. Ken, I'm wearing a chapstick hat. This is pathetic. I've got issues. Well, well, well. A royal flush. You're bluffing. I am. Serves up, dude. Pool water. That bowl is gnarly, except for those dirty yellow rings. Kenneth, what are you doing? You know, I don't even like honey. I don't even eat it. We need to talk. He's just a little bee. And he happens to be the nicest bee I've ever met in a long time. What are you talking about? Aren't there other bugs in your life? No, but there are other things bugging me in life, and you're one of them. Fine, taking bees, no yogurt night. My nerves are fired from riding on this emotional roller coaster. Goodbye, Ken. And for your information, I prefer sugar-free artificial sweeteners, my man. I'm sorry about all that. I know it's gotten aftertaste. I like it. I always felt there was some kind of barrier between Ken and me. I couldn't always overcome it. Oh, well, are you okay for the trial? I believe Mr. Montgomery is about out of ideas. We would like to call Mr. Barry Benson to be to the stand. Good idea. You can really see why he's considered one of the best lawyers. Yeah, Layton, you've gotta wave some magic with this jury, or it's gonna be all over. Don't worry. The only thing I have to do is turn the jury around and to remind them of what they don't like about bees. You got the tweezers? Are you allergic? Only to losing. Mr. Benson B, I'll ask you what I think we'd like to know. What exactly is your friendship to that woman? We're friends. Good friends? Yeah. How good? Do you live together? Wait a minute. Are you a little bed bug? I've seen a bee documentary or two, from what I understand. Doesn't your queen give birth to all the bee children? Yeah, but so those aren't your real parents. Oh, Barry, yes they are. Hold me back. You're an illegitimate bee, aren't you, Benson? He's denouncing bees. Don't you date your cousins? Objection! I'm going to excuse this guy. Adam, don't. It's what he wants. Oh, I'm hit. Oh, Lordy, I'm hit. Order, order. The venom. It's coursing through my veins. I've been found by a winged beast of destruction. You see? You can't treat them like equals. They're striped savages. Stingings. The only thing they know is their way. Adam, stay with me. I can't feel my legs. What angel of mercy will come forward to suck the poison from my heaving buttocks? I will have order in this court. Order, please. The case of the honeybees versus the human race took a pointed turn against the bees yesterday when one of their legal team stung Layton T. Montgomery. Hey, buddy, hey. Is there much pain? Yeah. I blew the whole case, didn't I? It doesn't matter. What matters is you're alive. You could have died. It'd be better off dead. Look at me. They got it from the cafeteria downstairs in a tuna sandwich. Look, there's a little celery still on it. What was it like to sting someone? I can't explain it. It was all adrenaline and then ecstasy. All right. You think it was all a trap? Of course. I'm sorry. I flew us right into this. What were we thinking? Look at us. We're just a couple of bugs in this world. What will the humans do to us if they win? I don't know. I hear they put roaches in motels. That doesn't sound too bad. Adam, they checked in, but they don't check out. Oh my. Could you get a nurse to close that window? Why? The smoke? Bees don't smoke, right? Bees don't smoke. But some bees are smoking. That's lit. That's our case. Is it? It's not over. Get dressed. I gotta go somewhere. Get back to the court and stall. Stall any way you can. I'm assuming you've done steps correctly. You read, Mr. Flayman. Yes, Your Honor. Where is the rest of your team? Well, Your Honor, it's interesting. Bees are trained to fly absolutely. And as a result, we don't make very good time. I actually heard a very funny story about Your Honor. Haven't these ridiculous bugs taken up enough of this court? It's volumes of time. How much longer will we allow these absurd shenanigans to go on? They have presented no compelling evidence to support their charges against my clients who will run legitimate businesses. I move a complete dismissal of this entire case. Mr. Flayman, I'm afraid I'm going to have to consider Mr. Montgomery's motion. But you can't. We have a terrific case. Where's your proof? Where's the evidence? Show me the smoking gun. Hold it, Your Honor. You want a smoking gun? Here's your smoking gun. What is that? It's a bee smoker. What, this? It's a harmless little contraption. This couldn't hurt a fly, let alone a bee. Look at what has happened to bees who have never never asked, smoking or non. Is this what nature intended for us? To be forcibly addicted to smoke machines and man-made wooden slat work camps, living out our lives as honey slaves to the white man? What are we going to do? He's playing the species card. Ladies and gentlemen, please free the bees. Free the bees, free the bees, free the bees, free the bees, free the bees. The court finds in favor of the bees. But as a one, I know you can do it. It's high five. Sorry, I'm okay. You know what this means. All this honey will finally belong to the bees. Now we won't have to work hard all the time. This is not only perversion, but as you said, you'll regret this. Barry, how much honey is out there? All right, one at a time. Barry, who are you wearing? My sweater is Ralph Lauren, and I have no pants. What if Montgomery's right? What if, do you mean? We've only been living the bee way for so long, too, 27 million years. Congratulations on your victory. What will you demand as a settlement? First, we'll demand a complete shutdown of all the bee war camps. Then, we want back the honey that was ours to begin with. Every last drop. We demand at the end to the glorification of bear as anything more than a filthy, smelly, bad breath stink machine. We're all aware of what they do in the woods. Wait for my signal. Take him out. Have the nauseation for a few hours. Then he'll be fine. And we'll no longer tolerate negative nicknames. But if it's just a plant about steel names, unnecessary inclusion of honey and bogus health products, a la-dee-da human tea time snack garnishments. Can't breathe. Bring it in, boys. Hold it right there. Good, tap it. Mr. Buswell, we just passed 3 cups, and there's a gallon more coming. I think we need to shut down. Shut down? We never shut down. Shut down honey production. Stop making honey. Take your keys, sir. What do you do now? Cannonball! We're shutting honey production. Mission aborting pollution and nectar detail. Returning to base. Adam, you wouldn't believe how much honey was out there. Oh, yeah? What's going on? Where is everybody? Are they out celebrating their home? They don't know what to do laying out, sleeping in. I heard your Uncle Cole was on his way to San Antonio with a cricket. At least we got our honey back. Sometimes I think, so what if humans like our honey? Who wouldn't? It's the greatest thing in the world. I was expected to be part of making it. This was my new desk. This was my new job. I wanted to do it really well. Now I can. I don't understand why they're not happy. I thought their lives would be better than doing nothing. It's amazing. Honey really changes people. You don't have any idea what's going on, do you? What did you want to show me? This. What happened here? This is not the half of it. Oh, no. Oh, my. They're all wilting. Doesn't look very good, does it? No. And whose fault do you think it was? You know, I'm gonna guess bees. Bees, specifically me. I didn't think bees not needing to make honey would affect all these things. It's not just flowers, fruits, vegetables. They all need bees. That's our whole stack test right there. Take away, produce, that affects the entire animal kingdom. And then, of course, the human species. So if there's no more pollination, it would all just go south here? Couldn't it? I know it's also partly my fault. How about a suicide pact? How do we do it? I'll just sting you. You step on me. That just kills you twice. Yeah, right. Listen, Barry. Sorry, but I gotta get going. I had to open my mouth and talk. Vanessa, why are you leaving? Are you going to the final tournament of Roses Parade? They moved it to this weekend because all the flowers are dying. It's all the last chance to ever have to see it. Vanessa, just want to say I'm sorry. I never meant to turn out like this. I don't mean either. Tournament of Roses. Roses can't do sports. Wait a minute. Roses? Roses, Vanessa, Roses are berry? Roses are flowers. Yes, they are. Roses, bees, pollen. I know. That's why this is the last parade. Maybe not. Could you ask him to slow down? Could you slow down, Barry? Okay, I made a huge mistake. This is a total disaster. All my fault. Yes, it kind of is. I've ruined the planet. I want to help you with the flowers shop. I've made it worse. Actually, it's completely closed out. I thought you maybe were remodeling, but I have another idea. It's just a greater than my previous idea combined. I don't want to hear it. All right. They have the roses. The roses have the pollen. I know every bee plant flower bud this bark. All we gotta do is get what they've got back there. What we've got. Bees, bark, pollen, flowers, repollination across the nation. Tournament of roses, Pasadena, California. They've got nothing but flowers. Floats and cotton candy. Security will be tight. I have an idea for Vanessa Bloom, FDT. Floral business is real. Sorry, man. Nice brooch. Thank you. It was a gift. Once outside, we just pick up the right float. How about the princes and peas? I could be the princess and you could be the pea. Yeah, I got it. Where should I sit? Where are you? I believe I'm the pea. The pea? It goes under the mattress. Not in this fairy tale, sweetheart. I'm getting the marshal. You do that. This whole parade is a fiasco. Let's see what this baby will do. Hey, what are you doing? Then all we do is blend in with traffic without arousing suspicion. Once at the airport, there's no stopping us. Stop security. You and your insect pack. Your float, yes, has it been in your possession the entire time? Would you remove your shoes, remove your sneaker in support of me? I know, just having fun, enjoy your flight. Then if we're lucky, we'll have just the entire pollen to do the job. Can you believe how lucky we are? We have just enough pollen to do the job. I think this is gonna work. It's gotta work. Attention passengers, this is Captain Scott. We have a bit of bad weather in New York. It looks like we're experiencing a couple of hours delay. Barry, these are cut flowers with no water. They'll never make it. I gotta get up there and talk to them. Be careful. Can I get help with the Skyball magazine? I'd like to order the talking inflatable nose and ear hair trimmer. Captain, I'm in the real situation. What'd you say? How? Nothing. B, don't freak out. My entire species. What are you doing? Wait a minute. I'm an attorney. Who's the attorney? Don't move, Barry. Good afternoon, passengers. This is your captain with Vanessa Bloom. This is 24B. Please report to the cockpit. And please hurry. What happened here? There was a dustbuster, a 2P, toupee, a life raft exploded. One's bald. One's in the boat. They're both unconscious. Is that another bee joke? No. No one's flying the plane. This is JFK Control Tower. Flight 356. What's your status? This is Vanessa Bloom. I'm a florist from New York. Where's the pilot? He's unconscious and so is the pilot. Co-pilot. Not good. Does anyone on board have a flight experience? As a matter of fact, there is. Who? Barry Benson from the Honey Trials? Oh, great. Vanessa, this is nothing more than a big metal bee. It's got giant wings, huge engines. I can't fly a plane. Why not? Isn't it John Travolta pilot? Yes. How hard could it be? Wait, Barry. We're headed into some lightning. This is Bomb. We have some late breaking news from JFK Airlines. This is Benson scene. Barry Benson is Barry. It's attempting to land. And then in the incapacitated flight cut flowers. We have a storm in the area and two individuals with absolutely no flight experience. Just a minute. There's a bee on the plane. I'm quite familiar with Benson. I've done enough damage. But isn't your only hope technically, a bee shouldn't be able to fly at all. Their wings are too small. Haven't we heard this a million times? The surface area of the wings and the body mass make no sense. Get to this on the air. I got to stand by. We're live. The way we work, mysterious. Making honey takes a lot of bees. Doing a small job. But let me tell you about a small job. If you do it well, it makes a difference. More than we realize to us, to everyone. That's why I want to get the bees back working together. That's the bee way. We're not made of jello. We get behind the fallow. Black and yellow, hello. Left, right, down, hover. Hover, forget hover. This isn't so hard. Beep, 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 beep. Barry, what happened? Wait, I think we were on autopilot the whole time. That may have been helping me. And now we're not. So it turns out, I cannot fly a plane. All of you, let's get behind this fellow. Move it out. Move out. Our only chance is if I do this, what I do, do you copy me with the wing of the plane? Don't have to yell. I'm not yelling. We're in a lot of trouble. It's very hard to concentrate with that panicky tone in your voice. Is that a tone? I'm not panicking. I can't do this. Vanessa, pull yourself together. You have to snap out of it. You 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 snap out of it. Hold it. Why? Come on. It's my turn. How is this plane flying? I don't know. Hello? Benson, got any flowers for the happy occasion in here? The pilot jocks. They do get behind the fellow. Black and yellow. Hello? Alright, let's drop this tin can on the back top. Where? I can't see anything. Can you? No, nothing. It's all cloudy. Come on. You gotta think, Barry. Thinking B. Wait a minute. I think I'm feeling something. What? I don't know. It's strong, pulling me like 20 million year old insects bringing the nose down. Thinking me. What in the world is on this tarmac? Get some lights on that. Thinking me. Vanessa, aim for the flower, okay? Out of the engines. We're going in on bee power. Ready, boys? Affirmative. Good, good. Easy now. That's it. Land on that flower. Ready? Full reverse. Spin it around. Not that flower. The other one. Which one? That flower. I'm aiming at the flower. That's the fat guy in the flowered shirt. I mean the giant pulsating flower made of a million bees. Pull forward, nose down, tail up, rotate around. This is insane, Barry. This is the am I cuckoo? Or is this plane flying in an insect-like pattern? Get your nose in there. Don't be afraid. Smell it. Full reverse. Just drop it. Be a part of it. Aim for the center. Now drop it in. Woman, come on. Ready, Barry, we did it. You taught me how to fly. Yes. No high fives. Right, Barry, it worked. Did you see the giant flower? What giant flower? Where, of course, I saw the giant flower. That was genius. Thank you, but we're not done yet. Listen, everyone. This one more day is coming with the last pollen from the last flower. Unavailable anywhere on Earth. That means this is our last chance. We're the only ones who are able to make money, pollinate flowers, and dress like this. If we're gonna survive as a species, this is our moment. What do you say? We're going to be bees or just Museum of Natural History keychains? We're bees, keychains, then follow me, except keychain. Hold on, Barry, here. You've earned this. Yeah, I'm a pollen jug, and it's perfect fit. All I gotta do are the sleeves. Oh, yeah, that's our Barry. Mom, the bees are back. If anyone needs to make a call, now's the time. I got a feeling we'll be working on late tonight. Here's your chance. You have a great afternoon. Can I help whoever's next? Would you like some honey with that? It has been B approved. Don't forget that milk cream cheese. It's all me, and I don't need a nickel. Please, I just feel like a piece of meat. I had no idea. Barry, I'm sorry. Have you got this moment? Would you like to excuse me? My mosquito is so shit. We'll help you. Sorry, I'm late. He's a lawyer too? I will already a bloody sucking parasite. All I need was a briefcase. Have a great afternoon, Barry. I just got this blue tulip order, and I can't get them anywhere. No problem, Vinny. Just leave it to me. You're a lifesaver, Barry. Can I help whoever's next? All right, scramble jocks. It's time to fly. Thank you, Barry. That bee is living my life. Let it go, Kenny. When will this nightmare end? Let it all go. Beautiful day to fly sure is between you and me. I was dying to get out of this office. You have got to start thinking B, my friend. Thinking B! Me! Hold it! Just stop for a sec. Hold it. I'm sorry. Everyone, can we just stop here? I'm not making a major life decision during a production number! Alright! Take 10! Everybody, wrap it up, guys! I had virtually no rehearsal for that!
Ha! No.